You're at 28840 Jaquinda Road, Warren, Michigan.
Think a story like this where you have it and others don't, you would put that behind your paywall. So
no,
I found that very interesting.
Evan, no, you put it out there for free. It's like crack. You make the money on the comeback. You don't make it on the first hit. You make it on the comeback because now it looks like you're ahead of things and you know something. So now the next article will be on behind the paywall, but the first one's always free.
That next little hit of crack. So here's my question to both of you. Is this, we can play this two ways. We did the same thing with Mel Tucker. Is this Harbaugh angling for a new deal? And he doesn't have an agent, but he's got people to back channel through that use the Raiders to get Michigan to pony up the money? Is this contract games or is it real? And look, I've made the case.
he fixed the house. He fixed the house, gave Mama a new roof, and now he can leave. You won the Big Ten, you beat OSU, you made the CFP, all sins are forgiven. He could leave, and I don't think you, out there in Michigan land, I don't think you'd be angry. And I think some of you, even though it's an unpopular opinion in a year that you went to the playoff, I think some of you want him gone still.
Yeah, and the, and the story also goes on to talk about why the Raiders, and he says the Raiders head coaching job might be tough for him to say no, given his ties to the organization. He started his coaching career there in 2003, and in fact, he already has a quarterback in place in Derek Carr. So it is interesting, and Feldman also does mention the Bears in there as well. So it does seem like...
Bears are cheap as the day is
long. They are, and you got to think this would be... Harbaugh getting every bit of that money that was cost.
The other thing Daniel Jeremiah talked about is the relationship that, look, the Davises and the Harbaughs are friendly.
Well, and you would think, too, since he just did it with Gruden, you would give him the keys to the ship and allow him to make the personnel choices, all of that stuff, right?
Yeah, Davis, but I think the thing that's missing, we don't know how Jim felt about taking that pay cut. Did he take it knowing, you know what, the second I get something better, I'm out of here? How dare you treat me this way? You know,
how any human being ever felt about a pay cut?
Right. Not great. That's what I'm saying. So now that he has options, he didn't have an option last year.
All right. So
he
let's
had to take it or be homeless.
Well, and just on the pay cut, he did talk about it this week, and he said he would work at Michigan for free, just to let you
know. That's a lie.
I'm just telling you.
That's a lie. Yeah. I mean, that's...
When you do what you love, you do it for free. You would do this for free, right, Mike?
Like hell.
Look, it is interesting, though, that his name's being brought up again.
No, it's not interesting. It's more than that. People need to now tell me, do you buy this or not? And then your reaction to it. And I'll just throw the number out and let's talk. 248-539-9797. Bruce Feldman has sourcing saying, oh yeah, this Harbaugh to the Raiders thing is real. That there's juice there. Look, it's not a conversation of should he go or not. Let me be clear, Rico and I as Spartans do not care. You can tell me whether he should go or not. Don't care. This is about whether you believe he will go or not, and whether you'd care if he will. Those are the questions and the conversations I'd like to have. But it was, again, first, both Rico and I talked to somebody who was touting this not quite a month ago, but close. Then it was Daniel Jeremiah and Bucky Brooks. Now it's Bruce Feldman. This is either an elaborate ruse, media tour, contract. He's the 11th highest paid coach in the Big Ten. Nope. 248-539-9797. I'm telling you.
Mike Hart.
No. Lil Bro goes full circle.
No. I don't see that happening.
Okay.
I can see him as offensive coordinator.
Nick Sheridan's back. No, listen, I want to hear from Michigan fans on this. And this isn't anybody trying to get rid of your coach. Unequivocally, let me state to you, I'm fine with him staying because he doesn't really do a lot beating us anyways. We're right in the trenches with you on that. So, straight up, the timing's right. It is. He's delivered on the message, so even the loyalists could never say, Jim, you owe us. There would be no unfinished business. He beat OSU, won the Big Ten, he made the CFP. That's the hat trick. They'll never have a season like that again, quite possible. And then you factor in the only unfinished business he really has is he's got to be able to sit down at the Christmas table with his brother and have a Lombardi trophy. He doesn't.
Michigan side. Harbaugh is good.
That's a great point. That's why you're in the media suite. Does Harbaugh get the BOGO deal? Do you let him walk? Well, I mean, look, I think we all agree something's got to happen, right? You can't just keep going in continuum like this where he doesn't go to the league, but he also doesn't get a contract. Something has to give them. So what is it? And if you don't believe what I'm telling you about it's the right time to leave, let's talk about it. If you look, I want you to come out of the woodwork. I know some of you are probably very uncomfortable to say, I don't care if he leaves. But it's okay, you're amongst friends here. It's a right move. You're amongst friends. It's okay to say you don't want him. It's okay because you're saying what I think a lot of Michigan fans are thinking. This was the perfect storm, magical year. But by no means is this going to be the norm. So therefore, a guy who we largely felt is a failure, maybe we just move on. So let's talk about it. 248-539-9797. Rico, anything else?
That's it, man.
Tremendous. Bruce Feldman.
TVs, Mike.
Well, you could buy a TV potentially.